inertia or the continuous distribution of mass. Which chapter going on in school?
Gravitation.
Is done.
Try doing it
apply that formula, alpha dm integral. It is very easy, this one. Anyone has done this? Okay. Focus here. Where is dm over here? I have to divide this entire circle into small masses, right? So this is the small mass. Let's say this is the small mass dm. What is the perpendicular distance of this dm? Radius only, right? So moment of inertia is integral of perpendicular distance, which is r square, into dm. Is r constant? Perpendicular distance of all the dms are same only. So r square will come out of integral. This will become r square integral of dm. Integral of dm is what? Sum of all the masses, total mass, mr square. Okay? So we have got moment of inertia of the ring about an axis that is passing through the center and perpendicular to the ring. About the natural axis, we got it. How much it is? Mr square. Okay? So please write down, if entire mass is located at a distance r, then the moment of inertia is mr square. Simple. If the perpendicular distance of all the masses is same, then the moment of inertia is mr square. Okay? Okay. If perpendicular distance of all the masses are same, the moment of inertia is mr square. Now tell me, for hollow cylinder, about this axis, what is the moment of inertia? Mass m and radius r. What is the moment of inertia of the hollow cylinder about the natural axis? Mr square. All the masses are at a distance of r only. Okay? And you can imagine as if it is made up of rings stacked over each other. Okay? So here also it is mr square. Is the moment of inertia of ring and hollow cylinder same? Assuming masses are equal. Right, only now. This n need not be equal to that n. Okay? Okay? So we have got the moment of inertia for the ring and for the hollow cylinder till now. Okay? Now please write down moment of inertia of the disc. Disc of mass m and radius r. About the axis passing through the center and perpendicular to the plane. Let me have it. How do you analyze this? How your DM will be? DM will be ring. This axis, about this axis. So I'll just give you a hint. You need to assume a ring of radius is small r and width dr, small r and the width dr, and your small r will change from 0 to capital R. Now you are basically integrating dI to get I. dI is for the dm. How much is dI for the ring? What is the moment of inertia? The mass of the ring, let's say dm. So r square dm. This is the moment of inertia of the thin ring. So you have to integrate in r square dm. So you have to write, now r is constant or not? When you integrate, small r is constant? No, it is variable. So now it will not be coming out of the integral. It will remain inside. So you have to write dm in terms of dr now. You can refer back to the center of mass thing we have done for the semi-disc. Similar way you have to do here as well. How you write dm in terms of dr? Refer back to the when we calculated the center of mass of the half disc. The way we have done there, how to write dm as dr, same way here as also you have to do. What is the area of the strip? The area of this strip is what? Is it pi small r square? Pi small r square is area inside that ring. I am asking you area of this strip. This strip. Yeah. Dr into 2 pi r. You can take this strip and make a rectangle out of it. So length is 2 pi r, width is dr. So 2 pi r dr. Now do it. The dimension of moment of inertia will be kg meter square. It can't be mrq. How to write dm in terms of dr? How to write dm in terms of dr? Correct. So dm is mass per unit area. Total area is how much? This is mass per unit area, right? That into area of the strip is the mass of the strip. Yes or no? Mass per unit area into area of the strip. What is the area of the strip? 2 pi r dr. This is my dm. And the same thing we have done for the center of mass also. For the same disk. Okay? Now calculate moment of inertia. Quickly do it. Done. MR square by 2, all of you getting it? Are you getting MR square by 2? Integral of DI. Integral of DI, how will you find? R square into DM. So 2M by R square into this will become what? R cube now. Like this, right? It will go from 0 to capital R. Okay? How many we got mR square by 2?
Okay,
right. See, you can't escape this. If you think that you can ignore and escape it, this will come and hit you where you will, when you write the exam, you will not learn on your own. You have to learn it here. If you have any doubt, ask. 0 to capital R, this will go. It will be R to the power 4 by 4. So this will be MR square by 2. Okay? Fine, so moment of inertia of the disk about an axis passing through the center and perpendicular to the disk is mR square by 2. The way we have written dm in terms of dr, exactly same thing we have done when we calculated the center of mass of the semi disk. Okay, so you have chosen not to go back home and revisit the notes or solve problems. That is why you're facing difficulty, and this difficulty will continue. If you don't do anything about it, don't tell me that I was sitting in a chair doing some schoolwork. This is not going to help you in any way. Okay, if you're not doing this, this will not improve. Isn't it very straightforward? This thing? Okay. And every time you deal with a disk like this, this is what you have to follow. Mass per unit area you have to find out, multiplied by the area of the strip, which is 2 pi r dr only. Same thing you have to do again and again whenever you get a scenario like this. Okay? And in class 12th, same mass could become charge. So you have to find charge per unit area into the area of the strip. It will be again total charge q divided by pi r square into 2 pi r dr. Will be dq, small charge in the strip. Okay? So you just need to learn once and then replicate it. But if you refuse to learn the once only, it will come and hit you hard in the exam. And you will not get zero, you will get negative. Minus one, it's not zero. What?
Minus 40.
You have to go.